Ready, start. The appellant, being the exporter of the aforesaid consignment, claimed for exemption on the ground that the purchase was exempted under Section 5, Bracket 3 of the CST Act. Stop. The said claim for exemption was also found to be genuine by the assessing authority and was allowed in full. Stop. The appellant also made a claim for refund of tax collected from them by the seller at the time of purchase of tea. Stop. The said claim was rejected by the assessing authority and it was held that they cannot claim for refund under Section 44 of the KGST Act, since they have not paid the tax to the department, but it was the sellers who have paid the tax, and therefore under the provisions of Section 44 of the KGST Act, the refund that could be made is to the dealer only, and the assessee, being not a dealer, no such refund could be made to the appellant or assessee. Para. Being aggrieved by the aforesaid order, the appellant filed an appeal before the Deputy Commissioner within bracket appeals, who considered the contentions of the appellant and upon going through the records found that there is an observation recorded by the assessing authority that the export sales is pursuant to the prior contract or prior order of the foreign buyers, and also that export sales are supported by bill of lading, export invoices, etc. Stop. The appellate authority recorded by the findings that the claim of exemption under Section 5, Bracket 3 of the CST Act is envisaged for the penalty made sales or purchase preceding the sale or purchase occasioning the export. Stop. However, with regard to the refund, it was noted that the goods purchased are taxable at the sale point, and hence the liability to pay tax is on the part of the seller. Stop. Accordingly, it was for the seller to prove that the sales are affected to an exporter in pursuance of prior contract or prior orders of the foreign buyers. Para. It was held by the appellate authority that since in the present case the aforesaid sellers, namely the planters who sold tea to the appellant and on whom the burden lies to prove before the assessing authority that his sale is for fulfilling an agreement or order of the foreign buyer, had not satisfied those conditions of discharging his burden. Stop. So the appellant is not entitled to refund. Stop. Over.